Chapter 271. Krishna and Uddhava. Uddhava is one of the Uddhavas who was always with Krishna, and who was very near to him. He saw the evil omens, and he heard the words of Krishna. He waited for the time to see Krishna alone. He wanted him all for himself. When he did find him alone, he went to Krishna, and falling at his feet, held on to them firmly and said, Krishna, Yogesha, you are the Lord of Lords, and you have made a decision. You are going to destroy the Shadava clan, and then you will go away. I guessed it when you did not avert the curse of the Brahmins, even though you could have, if you had wished to. You are the Lord Narayana, and could you not have saved us all if you had wanted to? You have a purpose in coming to this decision. I am not here to ask you why all this is happening. I have come to you to ask a boon of you, a favor. What do you want to ask of me? Asked Krishna with his hand in that of his friend. Uddhava was very dear to Krishna. You, Krishna, said Uddhava, I want you and your nearness. All these years I have been always with you, and not a moment has passed when I did not see you or talk to you. If you leave me, what will happen to me? I cannot remain here for even half a moment when your holy feet have become lost to me. I have ever been with you, and I cannot be alone after you are gone. Please take me with you and bless me. Uddhava was sobbing his heart out, and Krishna looked at him with his eyes full of love. He could never bear to see his bhaktas suffer. The Lord's love for his bhaktas was far greater than the love he had ever had for Lakshmi, his wife. With infinite tenderness, Krishna took the hands of Uddhava in his and said, You have spoken nothing but the truth when you said that my purpose is to lead the Uddhava house to its destruction. They will all die by their own hands. Brahma, Mahadeva, and the Devas came to me and asked me to go back to my abode. Once years ago, at the request of Brahma, I promised to take a human form along with Udisha, and the reason for this birth was to establish Dharma on the earth. I have achieved it, and I have nothing else to achieve now. There is just a week more left for me to finish the last of my tasks, the annihilation of the house of the Uddhavas. And as for the Dwaraka, the sea will break her bounds and enter the city when I am gone. My dear Uddhava, the moment I leave this earth, her glory will diminish, and Kali Yuga, which is waiting to be born, will occupy her completely. Do not live in the world abandoned by me. Men during the Kali Yuga will take great delight in committing sin. You will have to spend the rest of your time, the rest of lifetime, assigned to you in this world with your mind completely detached from your kinsmen and from everyone who have been all these days near to you and very dear to you. Let your mind be set on me and only on me. With an even temperament, move in this world of men waiting for the end. Let me tell you something, Uddhava. I will describe what Maya is. You will then know how to avoid getting entangled in its web. When the senses are in action, they perceive the world outside. There are sights which the eye sees, sounds which the ears hear, tastes which the tongue relishes, and so on. These experiences are called manumaya, meaning they are born of the mind, and so they are considered transient. This is maya. To a mind which runs in pursuit of these, which feed the senses, there occurs a kind of delusion, and out of this delusion is born what is called gunadasha. Gunadasha is a condition when the Atman becomes tainted with the gunas. This involves him further into the sea called samsara, and it is not easy for him to extricate himself from this morass. You should therefore control your senses and control your mind too, and stop these from straying into dangerous ground. Since you have been with me so long, you will not stray from the constant contemplation on the Brahman. Uddhava, shook his head sadly and said, "No, Krishna, it will not be easy. To withdraw the mind from the objects of the senses is not possible. When I say it, I, who has ever been devoted to you, what then of those who have no bhakti for you? This lesson you are teaching about keeping the senses under control is so hard to learn and harder to practice. Caught as I am in the snare made up of I and mine, I need your guidance to shake off this mire from my feet and reach firm ground. Tell me how." Krishna said, "Most of those who have tasted the worldly pleasures and have finally arrived at the truth have been mostly those who have done it by themselves. They have tried again and again and have finally succeeded in bringing their senses under control. First the senses and then the mind. The stigma of the vasanas has to be erased by one's own efforts. It is one's own mind which should be used to achieve the detachment. Man is given the power of discrimination, and with the help of this, he should arrive at the truth. Two things confront a man who is in search of truth. They are pratyaksha and anumana. Pratyaksha is what he can perceive with his senses, and anumana is what he conceives with his mind. The fearless ones who are not afraid to follow their quest, their search to the end, those who are proficient in the two schools of thought, Sankhya and Yoga, even they look only for me. The human mind comes to the conclusion that I am something apart from the things which can be perceived. When the mind is illuminated, when the senses are roused, when the eye sees or the skin feels, it is not on its own accord, but is because of something else, some other power which has got to be present. This is the anumana at which the mind arrives, and because of pratyaksha, which is the reality around us, and anumana, which is the speculation which is based on reality, but goes further, deeper, into the real nature of the pratyaksha. With these two, the wise arrive at the truth, which is himself. I will explain this further with the help of a story.